gathered here today to strengthen the mind as we explore the topics on mental health. So welcome to our mental health center initiated by the HR Department Training Office in cooperation with our counselors from the Guidance Office. I am Mrs. Benizana and it is my pleasure to be your MC for today. We will begin our program with a devotional to reflect on God's word and hear the parts and the participants. Our song service and the opening song will be led by Mrs. Heidi Vanilla, to be followed by the opening prayer of Mrs. Nimesha Digamuro. Then we will listen to a meditational song to be rendered by Ms. Mary Ann Fernandez and hear God's message through Dr. Levy M. Pamela. Our worship will go on tonight.
Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before Him with joyful songs. Let us raise our voices in song and invite God's presence to be with us. Shall we sing, praise Him, praise Him.
Thank you. Let's all bow our head for the word of prayer. Dear God, as we gather for this seminar in this mental thought, we focus and acknowledge the importance of this word. We ask for your presence to guide us in our discussion and lectures and to open our hearts to one another. Lord, we pray for each participant here today. May they feel safe and supported as we share our experiences and wisdom. Grant us the wisdom to listen deeply and speak with kindness, fostering an atmosphere of understanding and healing. Help us to recognize the strength and vulnerability and the power of community. May this gathering inspire hope, promote awareness, and encourage actions toward better mental health in ourselves and others. Ask all these things in the loving name of Jesus. Amen.
Lost in a world of confusion, walking through life alone, holding the hand of illusion. I was a diamond. You saved me.
Amen for that wonderful message in song. Amen. Okay. Good morning, everyone. Kumusta po kayo? Napagod po ba kayo sa bayanihan? Okay. Anyway, let's praise God for giving us this opportunity to come together to strengthen our mental health. Okay. So to start with, I would like everyone to please observe the picture on the screen. Okay? What do you think they feel? Or what feelings they projected? Yeah, okay. I heard it. Probably they are sad, confused, disappointed, hopeless, lonely. Okay. So, we cannot deny the fact that we feel the same sometimes, right? So, how do you feel right now? May I invite everyone to have prayer? How do you feel right now, ma'am? Excuse me, ma'am. Okay. Let's share our feelings. Can you choose one? All right. Thank you so much. Your feelings are all valid. God acknowledges our feelings, whether it is negative or positive. We have moments in life where the weight of our struggles is overwhelming. Times when our hearts are broken and our spirit is crushed. We are not sure how to move on. Maybe for you, that moment is right now. Maybe we have the feelings of loss, disappointment, grief, and anxiety. But the truth is, in that moment, God is closer than ever. In the silence of our brokenness, He is present. And what does He offer? He offers us healing, comfort, and hope. In Psalm 34:18, it says, can we read it all together? The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. This text holds significant meaning for our spirituality and mental health. First, God's presence in our emotional pain. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted. This verse speaks God's nearness in times of our pain, in times of our emotional pain. And His role is to give us comfort. For individuals facing mental health challenges like anxiety, depression, or grief, feeling spiritually connected can be a powerful source of support. Believing in God's presence during difficult times can provide comfort and reducing our feelings of isolation. So spiritually, this presence reassures all of us that God is very close to us. Second, healing for those crushed in spirit. Saves those who are crushed in spirit. The phrase saves those who are crushed in spirit suggests that God not only comforts but actively seeks to restore those who are deeply emotionally wounded. Are you emotionally wounded? Brought by hurtful events, relationships, or trauma. And it can stem probably in different situations such as betrayal, rejection, loss, abuse, or prolonged stress. And they impact a person's well-being. People suffering from mental health issues often feel broken, crushed in spirit. But God's promise is He will restore those who are deeply emotionally wounded. Now, there are some practical ways to strengthen our connection with God during our struggle when we feel that we are overwhelmed and we don't know what to do. The first one is prayer and honest conversation with God. When we feel those overwhelming situations in our life, come to God and let's vent all our feelings. God will not judge us. Express our pain, our fear, and struggles. Praying doesn't have to follow a special or a specific formula. Let us just give our negative emotions. Simply talking to God as you would a close friend can bring relief and help you feel understood. For example, it's there, Lord, I am broken. and overwhelmed. Please be near me in this time of need. But probably, sometimes when we are overwhelmed, our tendency is to withdraw, no? And we handle it by our own. But we are advised this morning that we need to come to God and have a conversation with God through our prayers. Second, meditate on Scripture. Reflecting on Bible verses that speak of God's love, comfort, and strength can be incredibly healing. In Psalm 34:18 is an example of a verse that reassures us of God's presence. We have there God's promises. The first one is found in Psalm 46:1. It says there, God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. And another one is in Matthew 11:28 that says, come to me. That is an invitation to all of us. Come unto me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. This moment, I want you to share your favorite text or God's promise that will strengthen you in times of difficulty. Will you please face your seatmate and share your inspiring God's promise? Amen. Thank you. And the last one is number 3. This is the last. Mali yung number. Reflect on God's faithfulness. His past faithfulness in our lives. Can you recall God's faithfulness in your life? Your past prayers answered by God. Reflecting on this answered prayer or reflecting on times when God has brought you through other difficulties can strengthen your faith. Can you recall some of God's faithfulness in your life? Or do you have a prayer journal where answered prayer by God are listed there? Okay, so I just want to share this. This is the one that we've been recalling. My husband and I keep on recalling this. God's faithfulness in our life. Before our wedding, we are in a LDR relationship or long distance relationship for almost 2 years. But the Lord sustained us. And after our wedding, I told my husband, since you are not a teacher, probably we will be assigned in Mindoro, in other remote areas of South Central Luzon Conference. Little did I know that the Lord has called me in this university to be one of his co-workers. And many more. We have as well stories of God's faithfulness. Dear colleagues, as we welcome the Sabbath, let us try to recall God's faithfulness in our life, whether it is small or big. And let's try to list down those things that the Lord has given to all of us. Dear colleagues, as we incorporate these three, we have prayer and honest conversation with God, meditate on Scripture, and reflecting on God's past faithfulness, we can experience a stronger sense of connection with God. And it is a very significant and very helpful to all of us to find peace, healing, and hope in the midst of emotional challenges. Let us all claim this wonderful promise given by God in this text. Once again, let's recite it all together. Amen. And may the Lord bless us.
Thank you, ma'am, for such an inspiring and engaging message. How reassuring it is to know that God is near and that He is faithful. As we transition to the seminar proper, I would like to extend a warm welcome to our esteemed faculty and staff, our participants for today. Can we give each other a pat on the back or perhaps a massage after the bayanihan? This is to recognize each other's presence and eagerness to learn and grow. Mental health is not just the absence of mental illness, but a state of well-being in which every individual realizes their potential, can cope with the normal stresses of life, can work productively, and is able to make a contribution to their community. Ellen G. White emphasized in the book Ministry of Healing, chapter 18, that courage, hope, sympathy, love promote health and prolong life. A contented mind, a cheerful spirit is health to the body and strength to the soul. Now we would like to invite Dr. Cheryl Ann M. Castillo for her welcome remarks.
Good morning. How are you? You know, it is often that when we are asked, how are you, the default answer is, I'm fine. Thank you. But are you really fine? This time, Dr. Levy has done an emotional check-in earlier, but let me do this again this time. Let us, if we are not okay, it is okay to say not okay. Let us normalize saying we're not okay. But I want you to... I want you to look at this photo in front of you. Look very carefully and feel which emoji strikes a chord in your heart. Which emoji creates bodily sensation? Okay, now let me ask you again, how are you feeling? Again, how are you feeling? Okay. Now, can you face your partner and try to mimic the emoji of your feeling? Thank you very much. That is called an emotional check-in. And I hope that you practice doing emotional check-ins every day. Did you know that World Mental Health Day takes place every year on what date? October 10. Okay. October 10 is World Mental Health Day, and the purpose is to spotlight mental health around the world, raise awareness of health issues, and encourage efforts to support those experiencing mental health issues. The World Federation for Mental Health, or WFMH, announced the theme for World Mental Health Day 2024. And so the theme of World Mental Health Day 2024 is Mental Health at Work. So this is actually AUP's through the HR, the Guidance Services, and the Psychology Department. This is AUP's way to support this cause. Respond as a response to this cause. We hope to do more, but at least with this, we can do a little bit every time. Okay. So, I want you to sit back, relax, and learn from our discussion and from our lecture. This information or the lecture that we will have, this seminar, will not promise to solve all your problems. But through this information, I hope that you can do also something for yourself, one information at a time. So before I sit, I would like to read to you a passage found in Philippians 4, chapter 4, verses 6 to 7. Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 to 7, and it says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus." Good morning, everyone.
Thank you, Ma'am Shean. That was only the welcome, but I hope we share the feeling of excitement and eagerness of what is to come after this one. After my part, we will have the HR to give her announcement, and then Sir Jether Patalinghog will introduce our speaker for this morning.
Okay, this is just a reinforcement of what we have distributed to you. We would like to have a baseline data so that we will have really good information out of our seminar. So before our speaker will speak, we really need your information. So please answer the survey. And please, this is very important because we need to have a comparison later. We will have a post-test later. So we really need your ID number so that at least we can have a comparison. So kindly, for those who did not indicate their ID numbers, kindly do it later. For those who are not yet able to answer, kindly raise your hand. Ma'am Elsie will give you the survey form. Sir Owie, and then who else? Okay, Ma'am Flores, Sir Flores, here. Okay, thank you very much.
All right, so once again, a pleasant Friday morning to our dear faculty and staff. And it's my pleasure to introduce to you our speaker this morning. I'm sure, although many of our AUP family knows about his numerous accolades and accomplishments for the past few years, and if I were to read his CV, I think it would certainly take some time. So instead, let me introduce him in a more personal way. But first, I should begin with his most important success in life. He is happily married to Dr. Wendy Jel Balila Guangco, a practicing physician. And I believe Sir Ralph would agree with that. All right. I first met him as an undergraduate student when he was teaching in the undergrad psych with his course, Positive Psychology. Even back then, I noticed his passion for psychology. And he later also became my professor in my graduate studies, continuing to play a significant role in my own professional growth. Our speaker this morning holds both a master's and doctoral degree in counseling psychology from our very own university. He is a dedicated faculty member of AP Department of Psychology, a registered psychologist and psychometrician, and a certif- and a certified specialist in clinical and developmental psychology of the Psychological Association of the Philippines. His professional affiliations extends nationally and internationally. He serves as the Global Engagement Representatives for the Philippines and newsletter editor for the International Neuropsychological Society. Additionally, he holds the position of the Vice President of the Philippine Society for Clinical Neuropsychology and is an international affiliate of the American Psychological Association. Drawing from his training, clinical expertise, life experiences, and spiritual faith, he inspires others to reach their full potential and grow closer to Christ. He firmly believes that those who love Christ will go on to carry out his works and serve others selflessly until he returns. One of his favorite quotes from the Spirit of Prophecy is, "We are all woven together in a great web of humanity. And whatever we can do to benefit and uplift others will reflect in blessings upon ourselves." His success, I believe, personally believe, is truly a testament of God's goodness and faithfulness in his life. Dear faculty and staff of our dear university, it is my honor to introduce our speaker this morning, Dr. Ralph Chason Guangco.
Hello? Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you, Jeet, for that very lengthy introduction. I gave the introduction, but it was very lengthy, but you dinagdagan pa. Okay. So I'm very happy to be here with you guys. And I'd like to thank Ma'am Annalyn for the invitation. We were playing pickleball, and then she asked me about it. And I did not, I did not decline the invitation. I proceeded with that. So I titled my very short presentation. I'm not into a lengthy presentation. So I would always have at least 45 minutes or less 30 minutes of your time so that I can share with you whatever I've learned in my practice, in my teachings, in my encounter with some of the people that I dealt with. So I have thoughtfully integrated both the scientific principles and the spiritual concepts here. So I'm not a pastor. Baka you would tell me, what's the biblical principle or basis for that? Well, I'm just using some of the principles from the Spirit of Prophecy and from the Bible so that I can really explain to you in a way that is as efficient as possible. I tried my best to harmonize every concept in the field of mental health so that I can present a balanced perspective of each of that. So we are here to acknowledge a very simple yet powerful truth: mental health matters. So I hope that we are prioritizing this. And when we think about health, we mostly focus on physical, right? Nutrition, physical health, what else? Fitness. But as what was mentioned a while ago, health is incomplete without mental health. Okay, so just as we care for our bodies, we must also care for our mental and emotional health. So let me give you first a disclaimer. So the information presented here is intended for educational purposes and should not be considered as a substitute for professional advice, diagnosis, or treatment. Baka po mag-self-diagnose kayo mamaya, ha? So we'll try it. I'm giving you a disclaimer so that we can, you know, we can adjust with what I'll be sharing with you this morning. Now, these are the specific outlines, the specific topics that I'll be sharing with you. So, what is mental health? The gaps in mental health. What are the common problems? Burnout, risk factors, and protective factors. And also our goals and future directions. So, I hope that everyone is ready. Ready na po ba tayo? Taas po ang kamay. Nag-ready na. Oh, may iba po hindi ready. Okay, so we'll start now with the outline. Let me start with Jeremiah 29:11. So, for I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. So, in times of our emotional and psychological distress, we may feel lost, distressed, uncertain about the future, and we can see that this is a wonderful reminder for each one of us that despite the difficulty, there is a positive outcome. And what is that? A future and a hope. So hope is actually a crucial factor. And as Seventh-day Adventists, we have that, right? However, are we actually thinking about hope most of the time? This is a positive concept, and many people are struggling with hope. They're losing hope. They do not know how to achieve hope. So right now, I'll be sharing with you on how do we understand those people who are struggling with hope. Okay? So, also I'd like to quote Mrs. White's Life Sketches quotation, train and discipline the mind by study, by observation, and by reflection. You cannot meet the mind of God unless you put to use every power. So, actually, inisa-isa ko po yan. Sabi dito, train and discipline. So, kung kayo po, when you want to develop your intellectual and spiritual abilities, it requires an intentional effort. Hindi lang yung parang, okay, alam ko na yan. And I'm very happy that you attended the seminar. This is one way to strengthen our understanding of mental health because that is an intentional effort. And we are guided by the spirit of prophecy that we need to what? Train and discipline the mind. The phrase train and discipline the mind can actually suggest that the mind, much like the body, benefits from rigorous and consistent practice. So we need to keep on practicing. So if you will read study, which is actually acquiring knowledge or understanding through learning, we also have observation there, which emphasizes being attentive to the world and experiences, and reflection, which highlights your introspection or critical thinking. So, medyo maliit lang. I mean, this specific quotation is not very long, but as you continue with your understanding of each line for that quotation, you'll be able to appreciate how important it is for us to be able to train and discipline our mind. Now, ang dami nyo na pong naririnig na mental health. Paulit-ulit. Pero sabi po ng science, neuroscience, when stimuli are learned by repetition, they are remembered better and retained for a longer period of time. So, repeated exposure po ninyo. For example, kasi you've been hearing a lot about, mental health na naman. Di ba? Most of the time, we've been hearing about mental health. Paulit, kahit nga po ako eh, nung tinanong ako, mental health na naman. So, paulit-ulit na lang. But you know, according to science, when you repeat it, you'll be able to understand, remember it better, and that you will be able to retain it for a longer period of time. So, mas maganda, mas strengthen yung ating mga brain cells, you know, mas magiging strong when it comes to understanding all of this important thoughts about mental health. Now, let me ask you, I'll walk. What do you think about mental health? Sige po, sino po kaya makakasagot? Kung alam po natin, kasi di ba naalala nyo na ito, may mga mental health is what? May idea na kayo before. So what do you think about mental health? When you look at the pictures right there, ano po ba ang mental health? What do you think? Sino po ang tataas ng kamay? When you hear the word mental health or when you read the word mental health, what comes to your mind? Ano kaya yung pumapasok sa kaisipan natin kadalasan? Sige ma'am. Ano po kaya? Sige lang po, let's just try to brainstorm.
try lang po. Ang mental health, meron ka nun pag wala kang ayusin na marami. Pag may ayusin o malaking ayusin, ay may suliranin tayo sa mental health. Ganun po ba yun?
Okay, that's one explanation. A very simple explanation. Ano po kaya ang mental health? Marami pong definition actually ng mental health. But I'll share with you a very important definition. For many, you can see all the time, thank you ma'am, it may remind you of images of therapy sessions, di ba? Pag mental health, ah, may therapy yan. May therapy sessions yan. Or may gamot yan. Or abnormal yan. O, di ba? Ganun po agad, automatic eh. That's the automatic thought that we have when we hear the word mental health. Or perhaps even stigma, ah, kahihiyan yan. Hindi natin sasabihin kasi nakakahiya. Lalo na po sa Adventist family, nakakahiya, or sa Christian family. It's difficult to share. Well, mental health encompasses a broad spectrum of emotional, psychological, social, spiritual aspects. So on how we think, feel, and behave in our daily lives. So here, let me share with you first that the Department of Labor and Employment has this. I hope that you are acquainted with this. And for our HR people, I hope that all of us are acquainted with the Department of Labor number 208 series of 2020. So here, it is mandatory that all workplaces and establishments should have or to formulate a mental health workplace policy and program. That's from DOLE 2020. Even the Republic Act number 11036, employers shall what? One, develop appropriate policies and programs, correct the stigma and discrimination, and identify and provide support. That's from section 25 of 10036. So you see, this is something na very important sa atin. It's not just other policies, but also I hope that we also have this kind of policies that that will take in place. Now, let me share you some of the problems that we have. The definition a while ago was given to us, but this is, I think it was mentioned na rin kanina, that mental health could be all of this. First, you are aware about your ability. You are aware about your capacity as a person. Then you have an effective coping skills. That's second one. The third one is you are an efficient worker and also you are an advocate. You share with other people. Now, the thing with this is that dapat meron lahat tayo niyan, component niyan. So that we can say that we have a mental health. Kasi if we don't have such mental health, then it may affect our daily lives and daily activities. And there's an additional one. That's from the World Health Organization. But there's an additional which Rogers suggests that it is also an emotional and spiritual resilience. So hindi lang siya yung self-awareness, effective coping, efficient worker, advocate. But when you're spiritually resilient and also you're emotionally resilient, you also have mental health. Now here, you may see a lot of literature news about the concepts of mind-body connection. Have you read a lot of that? Na kapag ang utak daw inaapektuhan, pati ang katawan naapektuhan din. That's what we call mind-body connection. And there are so many news associated to that. The Western concept of the mind-body connection traditionally emphasizes the relationship between the mental and the physical aspect of health, focusing on how psychological processes affect our bodily functions. And however, the thing with this, if you will read this one, they created a questionnaire to assess mind-body connection. But the thing with the Western concept, it does not incorporate spirituality. If you will look into this, mind-body connection is actually a Western concept. And it is because majority of the mental health practitioners in the Western countries are not actually confident or are not really knowledgeable about spirituality or spiritual concepts. But the thing with Filipino is that we are really individuals incorporating spirituality in all that we do, especially as Adventists. So Filipino mental health should be approached through a holistic integration of the mind, body, and soul, or spirit. That's why later on you will see what Mrs. White is telling us, that it's not just the mind-body, but it's also the mind-body and soul. There's a popular author of Psikolohiyang Pilipino that explains that mental health should be really the integration of these three. In many Filipino cultures, the concept of health encompasses not just the mind and the body, but also the spirit. Kasi tayo pong mga Pilipino, we always have a connection to God, right? This is a Christian country, and our culture plays a role in mental health. And here, you can see that Mrs. White even is supporting this. When we brought ourselves into communion with God, there is a transformative effect on their entire being, the mind, the body, and the soul. So the effect of such communion on body, mind, and soul is beyond estimate. So you see, our understanding of mental health is always like may connection ang ating pag-iisip sa ating katawan. But in reality, as a Filipino and even as Christians, as Adventists, there is a relationship between the mind, the body, and the soul, our spirit. And that is our connection with our Almighty God. Now, another thing is that when we have this connection, the spiritual connection, kasi very important yan sa atin eh. So when the mind of man is brought into communion with the mind of God, the finite and the infinite, the effect on the mind and body and soul is beyond estimate. In such communion is found what? The highest education. And it is God's own method of development. So please note here that our communion with God can lead actually to a very wonderful purpose, which is often linked to improve mental health outcomes. So when we have a strong connection with God, then we can actually improve our mental health concerns. So acquaint now thyself with Him. Now, after discussing that, let me give you a very short highlight of the gap in the Philippines. 13% actually of mental, neurological, and substance abuse or substance use would account for the global burden of disease. So 13%. Yet, ang problema po natin sa Pilipinas and even in other Southeast Asian countries, 75 to 90% ang hindi nakaka-receive ng treatment. They do not receive the treatment. Although may mga effective treatment naman na nag-i-exist dyan. So ito pa po, kulang din po tayo sa mga workers ng mental health. There's a lack of support for mental health, and the lack of human resources is dedicated to mental health is a significant issue that could affect us. So napakahirap po, lalo na sa Adventist community. May mga patients, there are some clients who would only want Adventist counselors or Adventist psychologists. They do not want other specialists. So that's why what we advocate is to really enhance, you know, the human resources. The lack of manpower, kasi po, it's an issue. Even in the Southern Asia Pacific Division, it's a concern. There are very few. That's why we keep on training people so that we can help them and address the mental health concerns that they have. And look at this one. For 100,000 populations, there are only 0.52 psychiatrists in the whole Philippines po ito. Okay, so nung umattend po ako last week sa Psychological Association of the Philippines, the Philippine Psychiatric Association estimated that there are only 537 psychiatrists in the whole Philippines. So, 0.52 lang po yan. And 0.07 na psychologist. Very few pa din. Pero ngayon, dumadami na po ng konti. Kasi this is a very old data, pero dumadami naman ang population natin. So, I mean, parang ganun pa din. So, also with mental health nurses, it's also a concern. So, ang dami pong gaps that actually lead to a disparity in improving our mental health. And also, if you can see, current news are highlighting a growing concern about the rising of mental health, particularly among young people. And actually, there's a recent study that suggests that anxiety and depression are increasing. So, let me proceed with the common mental health problems. But before that, let me share with you that self-diagnosis is wrong and it may lead to wrong treatments or lack of care for serious conditions. So I'll be sharing with you some of the common mental health concerns that you may encounter as you work with your coworkers. So first, let me highlight some of this. These are just the common ones. Okay, first, let me start first with a very simple mental health concern, stress. Well, every one of us has some form of stress because stress is part of our lives. So lahat po tayo ay mayroong mga stress sa ating katawan. Pero kapag sumobra yan, para pong yung goma, pag pinitik nyo ng sobra-sobra, binanat yun ng binanat, you will call that burnout. O, ganyan po ang process niyan, ganyan po. Stress, more stress, a lot of stress, too much stress, that's burnout. O, yun. Kaya, ang stress po, normal, kasi actually, in reality, it motivates us. It reinforces our activities. Pero kapag sobrang banat naman na po, yung pipitik na yung goma, ang nangyayari po, nag-burnout na tayo. Hindi nyo alam na susunog na pala kayo. So that's the thing. Let me share with you a figure later on. Now here, paano nyo po malalaman kung ang isang tao ay talagang tumawid na or patawid na sa kabila? Hindi naman po sa kabilang buhay ha. Yung sa kabilang ano lang, nagkaroon po ng mental concerns. Okay? So one simple way to remember criteria in defining psychological problems is by using the 4 D's of abnormality. The first one is deviance. Yung deviance po is more on certain behaviors may be viewed as abnormal in one culture, but it may be abnormal in it may be normal for you. But for deviance, ito po yung kakaiba na yung kanyang behavior. Like yung normal na behavior na expected natin sa society natin, sa kanya parang hindi na to normal. Especially for your students po, for our teachers here, if you've been observing some students who are not already in the norm, parang lumagpas na sila doon sa normal behavior na in-expect ninyo. So that is one specific criteria. The next is distress. Kapag ang tao po ay mataas yung level ng kanyang stress, then that could be also considered. The next one is danger. Danger to self at danger to other people. We call that psychiatric emergency. Kapag sinasaktan na po yung sarili or nananakit na ng ibang tao. Okay, so that's danger. And the last, which is very important, is dysfunction. Dysfunction is more on affecting the daily activities of the person. Kapag nanonotice na po natin na may mga problema na when it comes to the person's behavior, thoughts, feelings, na hindi na nakaka-work ng maayos, laging galit, laging parang irritable sa work, laging parang mayroon bang problema sa pag-iisip niya. That may cause dysfunction to occupational areas. What else? Spiritual functioning. Nagsisimba dati, ngayon hindi na. O, ano pa po? Maayos yung pakipag-usap sa inyo, tapos biglang nawala na naman. Hindi na nakipag-usap ng maayos. Well, there's another D, which is what we call duration. Yung haba. Kapag ang depression po ay lumagpas ng hanggang 2 linggo, ibig sabihin, kailangan na natin siyang ikonsulta. Kasi pwede nang papunta siya ng suicide. Pwede pong mag-lead to suicide. Anxiety, kapag more than 6 months, yun po yung mga duration. Kaya binabantayan po natin. We're trying to ensure that every symptom na pinapakita po ng ating mga patients, mga clients, students, or mga co-workers should be attended. Kahit minimal symptoms. Kasi po para pong posporo yan. Di ba, sindihan nyo, biglang lumilihab. Mabilis yung pag-ano niya. Kapag hindi po na-check, palala siya ng palala. Okay? So, let me go back to deviance. Alam niyo sa Pilipinas, may tinatawag po tayong ganito. Napanood niyo po ba ito? The mali-mali syndrome. This is what we call a culture-bound syndrome. So, it is a Filipino culture's bound syndrome characterized by thought, motor behavior, speech disturbance, obedience to irrational commands. They are easily startled. Pag ginulat niyo sila, mabigla silang magugula. And this one, actually, is not found in the DSM-5 or in our diagnosis or in our manual for statistical disorder. The diagnostic statistical manual for mental disorders. It's not found, but it is a culture-bound syndrome. So while it is not classified, sabi nila, ito daw ay may underlying trauma or underlying problem sila. History with them. So, you can watch that in KMJS para makita nyo yung itong symptoms na ito. It's a syndrome. Pag sinabi pong syndrome, it's a combination of symptoms. So, ang daming symptoms na nagpipresent dyan. It could be trauma, anxiety, depression. So, kaya ganyan po. Ito po ay very unique sa Pilipinas or sa Southeast Asia. You cannot find this in Western countries. So, it explains that culture is very, you know, very significant for us. Now, let me go back here. Now, sila, kunyari mga mali-mali syndrome, kapag sobra-sobra din yung kanilang stress, ang tendency, they may be dysfunctional na rin at some point. So, ganito po nangyari. Sa atin, when we are stressed, it will activate our autonomic nervous system. So, what will happen? Pag hindi po nag-work yung parasympathetic nervous system nyo, yung PNS, ang tawag natin, yan po taga-kalma, taga-preno. Na, oy, tama muna, pahinga ka muna, relax ka muna. Pag patuloy po siya, hindi siya nag-work, ang iisipin ng inyong utak, kasi nga ang gumagana lang, is his sympathetic nervous system. So, ang gagawin niya is, kaya ko pa, I'll push more, I'll do more, hanggang sa ini-stretch mo na yung goma. Sige, kaya ko pa. Ang tendency, nagkakaroon po tayo ng exhaustion or frustration. And ang nangyayari, marami tayong madalas nakakalimutan, marami tayong madalas na mali sa work, errors at our jobs, at our daily activities. Kasi sabi nyo, kaya nyo pa eh. Pero yung katawan nyo, hindi mo na nga kaya. So you rest for a while. Kasi po, pagganahin nyo si parasympathetic nervous system, para pong sa car, di ba? You use the accelerator at saka yung brake. Sa parasympathetic nervous system, you calm down. Dahan-dahan muna. Kasi kapag push kayo ng push, hindi nyo nanonotice ang sarili ninyo, then it may do negative outcomes sa inyo po. So, very important is to have a conscious control. Kasi yung utak ninyo po, yun po yung mga nangyayari sa may mga anxiety disorders. Sila, sobra-sobra na talaga. Hindi na nila alam kung anong gagawin nila. Kasi nawala na rin yung conscious control nila at some point. Nagkaroon na mga imbalances sa kanilang mga neurotransmitters. So we need to have a conscious control. And you can see here, this is a wonderful figure that you can see that even mild stress can impair the prefrontal cortex. So ano po yung prefrontal cortex? It's actually the seat of decision making. It is where God communicates. Alam niyo po ba yun? Ito yun. Itong front po ito, itong prefrontal cortex. And inside that is actually some specific brain structures that help you to communicate with God. So kapag impaired po yan, for sure, it will also impair your daily functioning. Now for those who are stressed out, then ito po yung mga nangyayari sa brain nila. So yan, nakita niyo po. Gulo-gulo yung directions. Look at the figure there. Yung red on the right side. The prefrontal cortex, amygdala, kung saan-saan pumupun, parang hindi siya maayos na directions. Unlike when you have a good state of mental health, what will happen to you? Diretso po yan. Efficient thinking, efficient activity, efficient logical reasoning, etc. Di ba? Mas mabilis yung pag-iisip. Pero kapag hindi po, wait lang, parang naglo-loading pa. You may be stressed out. Yun. So, in the Bible, sabi nga po, a person without self-control is like a city with broken down walls. So if you are not able to control, to have a conscious control of your life, to have a conscious control of what you're doing, then it will do no good to you. So the mind needs to be controlled. For it has the most what? Powerful influence upon the health when indulged. And it brings severe forms of diseases upon the afflicted. O, tignan niyo po. Science, Bible, and the spirit of prophecy. If you will look at the integration of this, you would notice na kung gaano kahalaga yung ating pag-iisip kung paano tinalagaan. Because when we do not take good care of that, then it will surely impair your daily functioning. You will expect na ang activities nyo po will be always in error. So here, another source of stresses for workers is burnout. Sabi nga po dito, burnout was the highest among employees in the Philippines. That's 70.71% Experiencing burnout was associated with severe or extremely severe depression. And you can see that is the cause of too much stress. So dapat meron tayong mga ginagawang mga activities that could lessen our stress level. Now look at this one. So you can see this is the cause of caring curve, but it could be also applied for us, no, na hindi nagki-care, or I mean you are handling yourself lang for self-care purposes. So here, when your performance does not match the level of pressure, ang nangyayari po ganito. Oh, burnout. Una, parang ano, mayroon po tayong tawag na rust out, nangangalawang naman, yung parang wala kang ginagawa, 'di ba? Pag walang ginagawa, parang ala, parang ampurol na ng utak ko. Ano bang pwede kong magawa? Now, here, if you are doing something, may level of comfort naman. Ayan o, rust out, minimum, average, comfort, and then may stretch. O yan, malapit na siya, papunta na siya. Pag hindi nyo po napigilan yan, pag pumitik na siya, papunta na siya sa zone of delusion. Anong ibig sabihin nun? Delusional ka na, nakaya mo na, ikaw ay superhero na. O tumawid ka na paunti-unti. Kasi dahan-dahan po yan. Tatawid ka papunta doon sa zone of delusion. Ah, kaya ko pa, kaya ko pa. Eh, delusional ka pala. Di mo na na-notice. And then, ang nangyari, nag-abot ka ng zone of delusion, na-reach mo siya, bigla-biglang parang, ah, hindi ko na kaya pala, pagod na ako. Ang mangyayari, mag-strain ka and then, ma-overwhelm ka sa work mo, sa activities mo. Kaya, nagpupunta na po tayo sa burnout. That's exhaustion. So, dapat nga, alam nyo po kung ano yung level of performance nyo. Ano yung kaya nyo? Kasi pag hindi nyo nakaya, for sure, papunta po tayo doon sa zone of delusion. Okay? So here, another thing is that, dahil nga sobrang zone of delusion, burnout tayo, nagso-social media na lang tayo. O, diba? Most of the time, manood na lang ng TikTok, o kaya manood sa Facebook, manood sa YouTube, or any activities that are actually impairing your ability. So sabi dito, kapag sobra naman daw yung social media, it is associated with mental health and well-being, lower self-esteem, and even poor sleep quality. Oh, sobrang stress ka na nga. Ang ginawa mong coping skills ay panonood na kung ano-ano sa online. Oh, diba? So yan ang naging coping skills natin. And because it could be because of other reasons, sabi nga po dito, this is the fear of missing out. So, baka hindi, kaya nga nag-social media kasi baka hindi na ako makasabay sa trends. So, ang tawag ko dyan, FOMO. So, fear of missing out. Yun, parang ito nag-trigger sa'yo ng anxiety na may bago na naman. Oh, yan. Kaya gusto mo lagi bago. So, ikaw, na-stress ka na nga sa work, na-stress ka sa social media, na-stress ka kung may bago na naman, so dagdag-dagdag-dag, umabot ka na ng langit. Umabot ka na sa taas. Sobrang taas na. Hindi mo na na-control yung sarili mo. So, our goal is actually to ensure na hindi masyadong mataas. Hindi masyadong ma-stress ang ating mga naiisip. Another thing, kapag wala po kayong tulog, ito pa nangyayari. Insufficient sleep increases, amplifies levels of anxiety, and conversely, that deep sleep helps reduce such stress. O ba, di ba, ang ganda? If you are having, alam niyo po ba, whenever we ask our clients during consultation, what we would always tinatanong namin, kamusta po ang tulog niyo? Tulog po, alam niyo po, it may be simple for you to think about it, but it is an indication kapag may problema sa tulog, it could be an indication of severe mental health concerns or significant concerns about their psychological health. So, kailangan pong tanungin, ano, kamusta ba ang tulog? Because if it is not, then it will lead to you to have an affected, impaired frontal lobe. Remember, the frontal lobe is a seat of decision-making and problem-solving. So, if you're not able to handle your stresses well, it will impair the frontal lobe. Okay, and then another thing, ito. Working more than 50 hours a week and being very dissatisfied with the job led to what? Higher jobs of burnout. This is a study in Southeast Asia, which includes the Philippines. So kapag 50 hours, sobrang 50 hours na po, expect that it will lead to burnout. Oh, excuse kayo. Eh, kailangan kasi ito kay may gagawin pa kasi ganyan. Ayun po. Ang outcome lang naman, kung gusto niyo naman gawin yun, nasa inyo naman po yun. It's your choice. No? Kung gusto niyo pong ma-burn out at maputol yung mga tali, mga ano ninyo, then it is your choice. Okay? Next one, anxiety. So ito po yung sinasabi ko sa inyo. These are the symptoms. Para mas maalala nyo po ng mas mabilis, worries. Yan po ang kanyang mnemonics or yung initials niya. Worry, excessive, uncontrollable, nawawala na yung control mo sa sarili mo, hindi mo na maiisip, tapos namamawis na yung kamay mo. Ano pa? Restlessness, racing thoughts, irritability, or easily fatigued, and then you also have sleep disturbances for more than 6 months. Kapag more than 6 months na, kailangan na po nating ayusin ang ating mga pakiramdam at pag-iisip. Now, statistics, 300 million have anxiety disorders. At ang mga karamihan ay kababaihan. 1.66 times more likely to be affected. And 1 in 5 for youths who have clinically elevated symptoms. Okay? And depression. Depression naman po kapag more than 2 weeks na, kailangan na rin po natin kumonsulta. So, these are the symptoms. Sigikaps. Yan ang pinaka-easiest na maalala ninyo. Kanina si anxiety, worries. Ngayon si sigikaps, problema sa tulog, nawala na ng interest sa trabaho o sa ginagawa sa araw-araw, nagkakaroon ng worthlessness, guilt feeling, pagkawala ng energy, na dati naman energetic naman siya, yung naapektuhan ang concentration at ang kanyang pag-iisip. Hindi na masyadong kumakain or sobra naman ang kain. There are changes with the appetite or less ang appetite. Psychomotor agitation, also with suicidal ideations. Kapag may symptoms na po ng suicide. Or kapag may suicidal agitations, then we need to seek help for that. Okay? Now, statistics, 5% of adults suffer from depression, which is approximately 280 million people. And 50% are more common for women than men. And 1 in 4 youth globally are experiencing clinically elevated depression symptoms. So you see? Then we also have the neurodevelopmental disorders. So ito ay kadalasan namin nare-receive sa amin pong services, sa AUP Psychological Services. So we do have, you know, may mga kids po kami that we are assessing, referred from the elementary, referred from outside, we are assessing them. So basically, ang neurodevelopmental disorders po are disorders affecting the brain development of children. So kapag hindi po normal, may mga speech delays, autism, mga ganyan po, autism, ADHD, specific learning disorder. We have a community service po every year sa Pook or sa Puting Kahoy Elementary School. And we assess neurodevelopmental disorders for kids. So sila po, mga 10 kids per year ang ina-assess po namin. And it's because it's very expensive to have assessment for these children. Before a therapy center could accept them, they need assessment. It may range from 8,000 to 10,000 pesos. So we provide them for free for those in the Puting Kahoy as our community service. Okay? Next, self-harm and suicide. 79% global suicides occur in low to middle income countries. And more men died by suicide 3.54 times more often than men because of not sharing their emotions. Lalo na po sa mga lalaki, mga husband po ninyo, may mga pagkakataon na hindi nag-share ng kanilang mga emotions. It's because they believe that they can do it themselves. Kaya na nila yun. At kaya napupuno. And to the point na mag-give up. And one person dies every 40 seconds. In general. By 2020, it will increase to 20 seconds. And right now, mas dumadami na rin po because of the what's happening in the world right now. Another last one is, this is the last one, personality disorder. Personality disorder po ay yung disorder na hindi niya alam mo disorder siya. Ayan po, kakaiba, di ba? Ang personality disorder po could be classified into different types. We have cluster A, cluster B, and cluster C. And we assess that. So ang tawag po dyan, may tatawag kaming ego syntonic. Ano pong ego syntonic? pakiramdam nila, normal lang yung kanilang nararamdaman na emosyon at ang kanilang behavior. Kahit nakakasakit na sila ng ibang tao, or kahit ang behavior nila is actually not the normal one, ang pakiramdam nila, it's fine. You do not care. Oh, what are those? Paranoid personality disorder. Iba po yan sa schizophrenia, pero pwedeng pumunta po doon sa schizophrenia. So, yung paranoid personality disorder, naiisip niya na baka saktan ako ng mga tao na nandito. O mamaya iniisip ko na baka mamatay ako mamaya. O kaya baka patayin mo ako. Baka malaglag yung mga ano mamaya. O yan. And then, what else? Schizoid personality. Yan yung gusto mapag-isa lagi na affected ng social functioning. And then, schizotypal, yun yung may mga paniniwala na mga aliens na ay parating sa Pilipinas o parating sa mga ganyan po yan. Cluster A yun. Then, we have the cluster B, antisocial. Yan yung mga nananakit. It starts in childhood. Before 15, ma-observe mo na nananakit ng mga hayop o kaya ng mga kung ano-anong mga animals outside. And then, kapag hindi siya na-treat, nagpo-proceed siya to possible problems when it comes to interaction na ng sa tao na parang wala siyang pakialam or pwedeng mapunta sa mga homicidal, mga ganon, cases. What else? Histrionic. Yan yung nagdadamit ng very, you know, very colorful, always talagang parang papansin. Yan. Very colorful, sobrang ano, parang flaunting the, ano, the yung dresses, tapos maraming mga designs. Sobrang heavy ng makeup. Wala, hindi ko naman po kayo. Parang tigilan na po kayo sa katabi. Ayan. Another po yan. Yung mga histrionic personality disorder. We have narcissistic. Ang narcissistic po, karamihan dyan mga ano. Just to tell you honestly ha. Hindi po ito dito sa AUP. Pero ang kaanuhan po niyan, ang narcissistic, common yan sa mga leaders. Yan ang pinaka-narcissistic person. They parang self-centered. Yan ang pinaka-problema dyan. Yung iba, parang hindi na nanonotice na narcissistic na pala sila. Pero kasi ang paniniwala nila, I stand with my belief. I know I am right. And I should be treated with utmost respect. Oh, yan. Yan ang narcissistic personality. We have also, wala na yung emotional stable. Avoidant personality, they don't want mag-interact sa ibang tao. Parang most of the time, ayaw ko makipag-interact. And then there's also obsessive-compulsive personality disorder. Meron din po yan, karamihan din yan ay mga leaders. Ang OCD po yung ok-ok, alam niyo po, pero extreme yan. Hindi yan yung OCD. Obsessive-compulsive disorder is different from obsessive-compulsive personality disorder. Ang OCD po is more related to yung parang mahilig maghugas ng kamay, yan. Mahilig maglinis, magkuskus. Sobrang linis talaga, organize everything. Oh, may anxiety component. But for OCPD, sila, organize sila pero wala silang pakialam sa inyo. They would do their own. So, ibig sabihin, kahit masaktan kayo, okay lang yan. Basta organized. Basta okay. Kahit, ha? Sa quality, oh yan. So gusto nila laging parang enhance yung quality ng ginagawa mo. Dapat perfect. Ayun, that's the term. You should be perfect. If you are not perfect, then you are a failure. Yun ang kanila. Pag may OCPD ang personality mo, ibig sabihin, ikaw ay parang bobo ka, matalino ako. Parang ganon. Wala silang pakialam talaga. And then the last is dependent personality. Yan naman ay more on parang kahit magtawid ng kalsada. Uy, matanda na, adults na, mga 20 plus na. Kailangan pa, uy, tulungan mo naman ako magtawid sa kalsada. Uy, tulungan mo naman ako sa ganito. Uy, tulungan mo naman ako sa ganyan. O, laging asking for help. Kaya nga, dependent personality disorder. Akala nila normal. Pero in reality, napupunta na pala sila doon. Tumatawid na pala sila sa kabila. Ayan po ay mga disorders, personality disorders. So, you can read further, you can download this. This is from World Health Organization online, even in App Store or Google Play, para makita niyo po yung different types of disorders. Ang binigay ko po sa inyo ay mga simple disorders lang. Or common mental health disorders. Now, there are protective and risk factors. I'm almost done. So here, protective factors, that's our goal. Dapat we enhance our protective factors. What are those? Good coping skills, physically healthy. Your family, there's love and support, positive parenting, lalo na po sa ating mga growing kids. Workplace, supportive boss, mental health program is in place. And then community, economic security, and safe environment. What's good in AUP is that we all have actually all of this. It's just that probably we're not discovering kung paano siya ngayon sasabihin na protective factor. Then there's another one, which is risk factors. Yan naman po yung nag-i-increase ng chance na magka-problema pa tayo. Sa tao, nahihirapang i-regulate yung emotions. Laging galit. Kaya madaling mamatay po yung madaling mabilis magalit. Okay? So if you are a hot-tempered person, that there's a high risk. Because that's a risk. What else? Low self-worth. Parang, alam, ang hirap naman ng buhay ko. Di ko na alam. Paulit-ulit yun every time. And then family, walang trust, walang respect sa bahay. That's a risk factor. Lack of warmth. Walang pagmamahal sa loob ng tahanan. Next, workplace. Unsupportive ang admin. Kung ganyan. So risk factor yan. Insensitive coworkers. Walang pakialam sa'yo yung coworker mo. And then, the last is cultural discrimination and more crimes. So the thing is that sa atin, sa community natin dito, nabawasan na ito. Ito na lang, workplace or family or individual. So community natin, di ba, very, walang crime or less ang crime sa atin, near. Meron man, pero well-handled, mga ganun po. Now, our goal is having to have, I mean, it's ganito po. Ang goal natin as a person is to have an increased protective factors para magamit po natin as resilience. Or pwede pong ang resilience kasi is a mental immunity. Para pong sa katawan natin, may immunity tayo, same lang din po ito. So we can help ourselves. Okay? So lifestyle changes matter. So by considering these factors, bio, psycho, social, spiritual perspective, we can actually advocate for that. Ngayon po, nasa-check niyo ba yung sarili ninyo? Ano kaya yung kulang ko? Ano kaya yung babalance ko? Kasi sabi natin, kapag sobra naman, mali. So paano natin i-balance ngayon? Biological? Let's see. Yan po ang example. Let me give you an sample exercise there. We always play pickleball with Ma'am Annalyn. So lagi kami doon, TTH. So we're playing. And some of the, maybe may mga friends kayo na pwedeng pumunta doon. Kasi open for faculty, yun eh, and workers, faculty and staff. For basketball, what else? Volleyball, what else? Do you have a positive emotion regulation? Your family is actually, you have warmth in the family. Sabi nga po nila, when it comes to family, kung kinoconsider nyo daw po na talagang ang family niyo ay importante, dapat i-consider niyo rin po na parang ito ay napaka-importanteng bagay na dapat niyong bigyan ng pansin. Parehas din ang pagbibigay niyo ng importansya sa work po ninyo. So as much as you give importance to your work, I hope that you also would give importance to your family. Also, to the foods that you eat, it has an influence to your mental health. So ano po yung mga kinakain natin? Kasi it may affect our mental health. Now, our goals in the future directions, what AUP can do would be this. Awareness. And what we're doing right now is to give you awareness. Second, we need to provide free and subsidized psychological interventions. So, yan na po ang mga possible suggestions natin. We can distribute helpful materials. We can host seminars or workshops. We can provide mental health training. And we can also combat stigma, encourage open discussion. At kayo po as co-workers, these are some of the things that you can do. Be committed to help. Encourage them to seek professional help. Seek professional help from emergency services and stay in touch. Okay, so ito po, let me share with you very short that General Conference has provided us 4 goals for us to do. What are those? Accessibility, education, encouragement, and accommodation. That's our main goal. And I hope that every one of us will have this. For accessibility, that everyone feels welcome and has access to all areas of life despite of their disabilities or mental health concerns. We teach them, we encourage them, to participate in all church life and accommodate them as God's family. So let me share with you the last text that I'd like to share with you. When we embody this principle, we can contribute to a workplace and school that actually nurtures mental health. So well done, thou good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter now into the joy of the Lord. So when we have that feeling, you know, when we have that mission in us, we can help more people. We can nurture mental health in the Adventist University of the Philippines. Okay, so I think that's it for today. So thank you so much for listening.
Thank you so much, sir. That was very insightful. And I think we will go out very mindful this morning. Our floor is open for the question and answer. Please feel free to raise your hand. We have ma'am, doctor.
Thank you, Dr. Ralph. I have a few observations. Your anxiety and depression statistics are obviously very high for women. Right. But your suicide is very high for men. Can you please explain the reason, the rationale?
From a neurobiological perspective po kasi, the brain of women is different. Differently structured when it comes to the brain of men. And easily po kasi, women are easily startled, are easily parang they're prone to a lot of stresses, and they're reactive. That's the thing. When it comes to the suicide case for male, mahirap talaga silang maka-express. They do not know how to express themselves. So common sa kanila ang depression, ang suicide, it is because they are not able to regulate their emotions properly. And another thing, when it comes to the statistics, just to tell you honestly, this is the statistics from World Health Organization, but there are some unreported numbers. So it may suggest, sabi nga po ng mga literature and authors, halos similar lang talaga sila. The thing is that, unreported lang nga yung mga nararamdaman ng mga lalaki. Kaya mas marami ang statistics na nakikita niyo for women. The thing is, hindi lang nare-report ng maayos for male participants.
Follow-up reaction. So I agree with you that the statistics may show that the women really express that they are depressed or they're anxious. The men hide it, but then they commit suicide. So medyo may problem sa ano, no? Sa detection.
Yeah, that's okay. True po, Doc.
Yes,
that's
may true problem po. Sa detection. But there's also an explanation why the men have a higher incidence of suicide. Mm. Kasi their means of suicide are effective.
Oh, wow.
Oo,
okay.
Talaga, gunshot gun. Mang ganun.
Yeah.
Yung mga babae, they attempt suicide, maghihiwa ng konti sa wrist, konti lang, yeah. Hindi nga tatagos.
Yeah, that's true po. Oh.
So that's another way of presenting your statistics. Maraming near successful suicide sa babae. Mm-hmm. Pero sa lalaki, successful talaga.
Yeah. Kasi ang lalaki po, very decisive eh. So, it also, it comes with their personality that when they decide, they will do it. Unlike with women, magguhit, sabi nga po ni Doc, magguhit lang yan, tapos, masakit. Tapos, mamaya na lang uli. O yun, ganyan. So, tapos, may nakausap na siya, na-express niya na yung pakiramdam niya. So, na-share niya na, nawala na. Tapos, maya-maya naman, may trigger na naman. Babalik na naman. The same uli, process. Kaya, you would see a lot of those, may mga suicidal cases, mas madami lalaki. Kasi, pag sinabing yes, yes, go, yan. Automatic yan. So, kaya, sa atin po, kung may mga boys, kay lalo na 14 teenagers, mataas po kasi ang cases natin with also with teenagers. Automatic, mabilis sila kasi changes with the hormones and everything.
Do we have more questions? Meron pa po? I have here, Doc, may nagpadala ng sulat. What do you do if you think that the reason for your stress is because of a faulty system in your workplace? And yet, even if you have already shared your concerns to the right persons in authority, no response was done.
That's a valid question. And it requires a very detailed answer. But I think the most important priority is self-care. So, alagaan muna natin yung sarili natin. Kung wala talaga, na naman tayong magagawa? So, what you can do is, may magagawa ka pala sa sarili mo. It's how you react to the system that matters. And then there's an additional answer.
We also have to determine whether the faulty system is a faulty system that is acknowledged by everyone, because it could be that a faulty system is your interpretation. Not necessarily that the system is faulty, but it is your lens. It is how you view the situation. And to that, I think, tama po yung sinabi ni Dr. Ralph, what you have to change is how you react to it. Because yung system kasi, we cannot control, because we are not the ones controlling the system. But what you can control, you focus on what you can control. So what you can control is how you react to the situation.
Thank you. I think our letter sender is satisfied. By the way, while waiting for the next question, paging, meron tayong 3 questionnaires that do not have ID numbers. I think our questionnaires need to be, they will be used for a post test sometime later. 2 from CON and 1 from AUPE. So I don't know, maybe we can try to scan our frontal lobes. Maka maalala. And then, do we have more questions? Okay. Thank you so much, Doctor, for the wonderful presentation. Let's give him a round of applause and ourselves a round of applause for showing eagerness and coming here today. We will present a certificate of appreciation to our speakers this morning. Let me read the citation. The Adventist University of the Philippines Certificate of Appreciation is presented to Dr. Ralph Jason F. Guanco, in grateful recognition of his dedicated service and commitment to the university as the resource person during the mental health seminar given this 4th day of October 2024 at the Finster Hall of All Nations, AUP Campus, Puting Kahoy, Silang, Cavite. Signed, Dr. Annalyn O. Bacolod, Training and Recruitment Officer, Human Resource Office, Dr. Arceli H. Rosario, President, Dr. Lolina T. Mostaza, Director, Human Resource Office. Thank you. And also a certificate of appreciation to Dr. Levy M. Fahanilan for serving as our devotional speaker for today. And of course, the early birds catch an umbrella. We have Ma'am Raquel Capiendo and Ma'am Janine Guzago. The first two. We have four more items, AUP bags, up for grab. But I think we need you to pick a number. We have here two sets of 1 to 20. So 1 to 23. So we will have from the first 1 to 10. Kung naalala niyo yung number ninyo, baka you can raise your hand and then tell me. Ah, si sir. Okay. Erase. We will have Sir Ralph to give us a number. Number 7. So we have Ma'am... Sir Japheth De Lima. Kasi taken na isang number 7. If he's here, he can receive an AUP bag. Number 5, Ma'am Crescentia Carpizo and Sir Junmar Pakanan. Congratulations. Sir... Number 3, Sir Emilito Rumarate and Sir Nicey, Ma'am Nicey Sanidad. Oh. Ma'am Castillo, got. So we will be having an evaluation that will be sent to you through your through our email account. So let's take time to answer the evaluation for today's event. So as we close, can we give each other a round of applause, our speakers, our coordinators, and ourselves for coming here this morning? And thank you, everyone, for contributing to a meaningful discussion. I hope that as we came today with an open mind to be very mindful, we will be able to use our knowledge in mental health to and give ourselves the best self-care that we deserve so that we can also render our services to the best of our abilities. Now let's give the time to Ma'am Annalyn Bacolod for her closing remarks, to be followed by the closing prayer to be led by Pastor Crisostomo Ansus Jr.
Okay, now we know. So if you feel those symptoms for stress and depression, please come to the HR office. Now we know what to do. We will prescribe you with a one-day deep sleep. Ah, ganun lang naman pala. Just come. Okay, we will tell you what to do. Pero sleep lang pala. Thank you very much, Sir Ralph. I hope we learn. Okay. So, I hope we really learned and enjoyed our seminar today. we will have more of this. Di ba, Ma'am Cheyenne, we will have a series of mental health programs. So we will have an announcement later. Please come and invite others, your colleagues who are not here, to come and join and share the good news of what you have learned. Thank you once again to our speaker, Dr. Ralph, to all our participants. And let's continue to inspire and encourage each other for God's glory as we work here. Good morning.
Shall we arise for prayer? Let us pray. We bring back all the glory and honor to you, Lord, for sending us Dr. Ralph to the success of this program, Lord. You are so good and so great for choosing this university to have this kind of program. Help us, Lord, to grow in grace where we can be a blessing to others and to all the people whom you have chosen to be in our responsibility. Guide us, O Father, and please forgive us whatever sin we have committed against thee, and make us a blessing everywhere we go. For thy glory, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.